All right, they can wait a couple more nights because they've waited 49 years. You can see longest gap between Stanley Cup final appearances. Nobody longer than the Blues right now. 49 years, and 49 years ago in 1970, it did not go well. The Bobby Orr game-winning goal in Game 4 as the Bruins swept that one to win the Stanley Cup. The Wings, prior to that, a stretch of 29 years. Nobody was worse in the NHL back on January 3rd, dead last. Nobody's better than them out west right now. Western Conference champions heading to the Stanley Cup final. How did they turn this around?
Really, I mean, it started with Craig Berube taking over. And once Craig Berube was in, because the team was underperforming, it's not an indictment of Mike Yeo. The team was just underperforming. And if you're Doug Armstrong, you made a lot of moves. You made a lot of roster moves, starting with your centerpiece in Ryan O'Reilly. And even when the team was struggling, Rupper, he was the best player on that team from the outset. And then they went to the fourth goalie in their organization by the name of Jordan Binnington. And they started believing, they started buying into what Craig Berube was saying. Guys, we need to play 200-foot game. Guys, we need to play on both sides of the puck. We need to be hard to play against. Let's defend hard with intensity in our D zone. Let's help our goalie. That's going to allow us to score goals. The rest is history.
Yeah, you know what? I'm going to look at it from a different vantage point, a different angle, and that's the job that Doug Armstrong did. And you date back to last summer, the moves he made to put this team. I mean, going into this season, we all thought, I thought this team was going to win that Central Division or at least contend for that. In the way it started, I mean, I never would have suggested that at January 3rd it was going to be this. Now, them going to Stanley Cup Finals. So he has loaded up this team on paper with the horses to get it done. Figuring it out, like you mentioned, by Berube and company was everything to kind of make them become one cohesive unit. But also, let's not forget, there was talks at different times of the year about trading Vladimir Tarasenko. And look how dominant he's been. So you got to give each guy in individual categories their own props for just fighting through, dealing with the adversity, and look where they are now. I mean, it's one of the greatest stories I've seen in our game.
No question. I mean, guys, look at Patrick Maroon even. A St. Louis native.
Right.
That called Doug Armstrong. Say, hey, listen, I want to play here.
Took a pay cut.
I'll take a one-year free agent on the market. I want to play here. I'll take less money, one-year deal. I'll bet on myself. I'll bet on my city because he's a proud St. Louis native. And, of course, a lot of that was centered on wearing that blue note for the first time, but also spending more time with his family. This is an incredible story.
And last round for him, game 7, overtime hero.
Totally. Had not for him.
Right.
They're not here. J-Mo.
Exactly. And then another one, too, David Perron. He's bounced around a little bit in his NHL career, but he has always been, in my eyes, a St. Louis Blue 3 times. This is his 3rd time back in St. Louis now, and he gets to rep the team in the Stanley Cup Finals. So many good storylines.